And now we're getting into the media review portion of our show, or as Professor Van Helsing calls it,
the ghastly paraphernalia of our beneficial trade.
Every time. He nails it every single time. Today we're going back to the silver screen, and our subject today is Dracula's Daughter. Dracula's Daughter was released in 1936 as an intended sequel for the 1931 version of Dracula. And if you want to find out how to consume Dracula and take a listen to our in-depth review, please go back to the very first episode on our revised podcast. Dracula's Daughter was written by Garrett Fort, and it was directed by Lambert Hillier. Lambert Hillier also has a very interesting tie to popular culture, as he was the director of the very first screen incarnation of Batman. That was in 1943. The film stars Otto Kruger, Gloria Holden, Marguerite Churchill, and Edward Van Sloan. Edward Van Sloan, surprisingly, is the only person to reprise his role from the original story, as he plays Professor Van Helsing. So the story itself talks about Countess Maria Zaleska, who is indeed the daughter of Count Dracula, and guess what? She also suffers from the same disease. And that's the key to the story. They analyze vampirism as a disease, a mental condition, a psychological disorder, something that can be explained away by medical science. However, things go awry. Though it's called Dracula's Daughter, the story is really about Dr. Jeffrey Garth, who is Otto Kruger's character, and his attempts for romance. His life has been interrupted by Dracula's daughter. I'm not going to spoil too much of it for you. This film is interesting in a bunch of different ways. Commercially, it wasn't very well received. It had a $278,000 budget, but part of the reason why it didn't do so well is because Lugosi wasn't on board. This movie often divides a lot of film critics. Dracula's Daughter is also interesting because it's the first film which indirectly touches the lesbian vampire trope. And that actually goes back to Carmilla, which is from Joseph Sheridan Le Fanu. It was a novella released in 1872. There's a scene in the movie where Countess Zaleska goes on the streets and finds a model to paint. It's implied that there is some sort of romantic relationship. It's not at all graphic, and it is artfully and tastefully done, but the censors, as you might be able to guess, took a stand against it. But the focus of this film really should be on the performances. And why I like this film so much is it doesn't necessarily take itself too seriously. It's funny, especially between Otto Kruger and Marguerite Churchill. They've got a lot of good chemistry in it. Edward Van Sloan sort of plays the same character, but he brings a lot of gravitas to the film, which is desperately needed. This film does get the Dracula podcast seal of approval. Unfortunately, you can't buy it on Blu-ray. There's a bunch of different ways you can purchase it. Universal Studios is notorious for putting their films into collections, more specifically their classic monsters properties. They released one around Halloween last year, which is actually quite expensive. It's $114.40. You get 30 films, but actually, it's really not that good a value, and a lot of the films on here you won't watch. The best way to consume Dracula's Daughter and to get the most value out of it is to buy Dracula the Complete Legacy Collection on DVD. Again, it's unfortunate that this thing isn't on Blu-ray, so you can get the detail. Universal is very good. We've ripped them pretty hard on the show for Dracula Untold and the NBC version of Dracula, but what they do is they do film restoration a lot of justice, and this thing should be put on Blu-ray. However, for now, buy Dracula the Complete Legacy Collection on DVD. Right now it stands at $20. There is a ton of value inside it, and actually this Dracula Legacy Collection was released back in 2004, but this takes it a step further. Not only do you get the 1931 version of Dracula, which has all the documentaries inside, but you also get Dracula's Daughter, The Son of Dracula, House of Frankenstein, House of Dracula, Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein, which is another great movie. You get an introduction to the Spanish version of Dracula by Lupita Tovar. It's a really good package, and that's the best way you can buy it. We're not big believers on going out and spending over $100 on really any media property. This is the best value for your collection. Once again, it's Dracula the Complete Legacy Collection. It's $19.99. There you can watch Dracula's Daughter, and you can get a lot of other films, and it gives you context and where Universal wanted the character to go. Go ahead and buy that DVD today. Unfortunately, it's not Blu-ray. but make a lot of noise and hopefully that'll change.